Hi, everybody. This is Ken Corbin, and welcome once again to the Manufactured Home Show. This is the program where I have the opportunity to talk and interview and chat with the absolute best of the best in our industry. From communities, manufacturers, suppliers, lenders, and today, one of the top, and I mean one of the premier manufactured housing managers in our industry, Ms. Sue LeBlanc from Clayton Homes in New Iberia, Louisiana. But before we talk to Sue, and always remember, if you'd like to see this interview again with Sue, there's a few things you can do. You can go to my website, callkencorbin.com, and on the top right-hand side, there's a little link that says Manufactured Home Show. You can push on that and you'll see the interview. You can also go to learnmh.com and there's a little link that says Program and Learning. You'll see, press that button. They'll all populate there. Of course, you can always go to YouTube and, pardon me, my Facebook page, which is Ken Corbin Speaker. Now, if you have any thoughts on the program, perhaps you know someone who would be a great guest, or maybe you'd like to be a guest, simply drop me an email to Ken at callkencorbin.com. And with that, let me introduce to you today, I mean someone very special, which is Sue LeBlanc, who was born and raised in New Iberia, Louisiana, and has been in the manufactured housing business since 1998. In 2004, she joined Clayton Homes and has spent the last 13 years as the general manager in her own hometown at their location in New Iberia. Sue has a long list of accomplishments, including being appointed by the governor of Louisiana as housing commissioner, chapter president of the Manufactured Housing Association, and currently sits on the state board as vice president. Her wonderful family includes Roger, who she's been married to for 35 beautiful years, daughter Kelly, son-in-law Josh Moore, and two beautiful grandchildren, Jameson and Finn. When Sue's not working and selling homes, she thoroughly enjoys traveling, reading, crocheting, but most importantly, spending quality time with those beautiful grandchildren. Her favorite book is The Energy Bus by John Gordon, who Sue insists is an absolute must read for everybody watching and listening. And Sue's favorite quote is, "What good is your life if you never live it? What good is your story if you never tell it? And what good is your smile if you never share it?" And with that, ladies and gentlemen, I am so pleased and honored to introduce my dear friend and today's very special guest, Miss Sue LeBlanc. Sue, how the heck are you?
I'm great. Good morning. And thanks for asking me on the show.
Well, Sue, I've got to tell you, you and I have chatted about this program. You've attended my programs. We've chatted. You are such an inspiration to our industry and such a tremendous leader. The work that you do on a national level, on a state level, even in your own local community, it's such a tremendous inspiration. But let me start off by asking you this, a basic question. Tell me what life experiences brought you to the manufactured housing business. What said, hey, I want to enter the manufactured housing business and be a successful person?
Well, it was by accident, actually. For years and years, I worked at our fruit of the loom plant in Generette, Louisiana.
Okay.
And when they started moving everything overseas, we all became displaced workers. So back at that time, we needed a two-income family. So I answered an ad in the paper that was looking for a salesperson. Now, let me give you a little bit of background. And you won't believe this about me, but I was very, very shy. afraid to get up and speak in front of anyone. I would actually take a bad grade in school before I would even stand up in front of the class and give a report.
Oh my.
So with that being said, yes, me. So with that being said, I answered the ad, and the general manager at the time liked me, gave me a chance. So never sold anything before. I became top salesperson there for multiple years and just loved every bit of this industry, just knowing that I could help someone achieve their dream of owning a home. So it's just been fantastic.
Well, you know, it's so funny. You talk about the fear of speaking. And of course, I have an opportunity to chat and talk and speak to groups all across the country. And people often say to me, Ken, it must be so easy for you. You know, you never get nervous, you never get worried. And I tell them every time, when I go to talk in front of a group, no matter if I've been with that group 20 times or it's the first time, I'm always nervous. So, you know, to prepare like you have for the career that you've had and to do the things that you've done, it's absolutely remarkable. But, you know, there's a lot of people that are watching this video or listening to the podcast. And for people maybe that are entering the sales business, maybe even people that have been in it for a long time, is there something you might share, maybe some key factors that you feel have helped you to be successful that can assist them to continue in their pursuit?
Sure. To me, the main thing is to be yourself. People don't want to be sold. They want to buy. So they want to buy from someone that they trust, someone that they can relate to. Just to me, being yourself, being the person that you are, can make a salesperson or anyone very successful. You treat people as you would like to be treated, and it makes a world of difference by just being yourself. Don't fake it to make it, because it doesn't work.
You know, that's so true. When a customer comes in and they talk to Sue LeBlanc about buying a home, they're not buying the home from Clayton. They're buying the home from Sue. And,
exactly.
and you have done such a great job. I like to call it being a chameleon, being able to relate with that customer, you know, show them true empathy.
Exactly.
To put yourself in their shoes, help them to know that you're there to help solve their problem. They're there to help solve a problem. They have a housing issue. And you've
exactly.
been so successful. But one of the keys I know that has driven your success is customer service.
Oh,
and maybe you could share with us your thoughts on us on customer service and why it's so important.
Well, again, I was born and raised in New Iberia, Louisiana. So I shop at our local Walmarts. I shop at our local Rouse's, our local, just all of our local stores. So for one thing is I sell a lot of homes to people in this area. I will never, ever run and hide from anyone that I've sold a home to. Because I meet up with these people at the grocery store, at the movie theater. So, you know, you always want to treat your customers with kindness and care. And, you know, when I meet up with them at the grocery store, I'm not going to hide. I'm personally going to go up to them and say, hey, how are you? How's everything going? Are you still loving your new home? And even if there is an issue, they have my cell phone number. They have our office number. They can call me at any time, and they know that I will pick up that phone and speak to them. So customer service is very important. It's very important to get referrals. A happy customer will tell, you know, just a few people how happy they are. An unhappy customer will tell the whole world how unhappy they are. So by treating people with respect and with dignity and with care, they are going to give you referrals. And that is a lot. Our main goal in this business is to get referrals.
I have to tell you, I have a number of clients that I've worked with across the country. And I've been very fortunate that I've worked in all 48 of the continental United States. And whenever I visit a sales center and speak to either an owner or a salesperson, and that individual does not want to put their cell number out there to a customer, that gives me a huge red flag. And I use the example of realtors. You know, you get any realtor card and you're going to see two things. Number one, you're going to see their picture on their card because visuals are so important. But most importantly, you're going to see that cell number so they can be contacted. And if someone doesn't want to put out their cell number, that tells me there's a problem. And generally, it relates, as you mentioned, to service. And, you know, we're not perfect. We're not perfect. And it's how we respond and how we react when an issue comes up. So I congratulate you. And what a great life lesson for the people watching or listening to this program. Now, in addition to this, you're involved, I know, very heavily with the Louisiana Association. And I've had the pleasure, as you know, of working with them for a few years now and doing all these programs. But there are so many things that Louisiana does for their members that are fantastic, continuing education programs, you know, the Tri-State Conference and so forth. But what are the things that you see that keeps your members coming back year after year after year that's so important in your beautiful home state?
Well, first of all, I want to give a little shout out to our staff, Wendy and Steve and Lenny. Those guys are fantastic at what they do. They're reachable 24/7. Any questions, any concerns, they're there to help you with them. And our association, we do the lobbying and for the industry issues during our state legislative sessions. So, you know, they're always up at the Capitol speaking to our congressmen, our senators, doing whatever they can in order to move our industry forward. There's so many stigmas against our product that those guys do a phenomenal job getting with the local governments to, you know, get us in areas where people don't want us.
Oh, absolutely. You know, they, I think many states could get a hold of Steve or Wendy or anybody down at the group and learn and all the wonderful things that they're doing. And that's the reason why your membership as a percentage of the entire industry is so high. You know, right now we're in the midst of doing, we just finished, as you know, the sales training with all the salespeople there in Louisiana. Right. And now we're doing a whole new group of six sessions on management. And these are things that I think can only help to have our industry grow, prosper, and get rid of some of those stigmas that you just mentioned, that in many cases, frankly, we were the culprit, but that was in the old guard, and the new guard that's coming in like yourself, they're just doing a fantastic part. But speaking of parts, Sue, tell us what your favorite part of our industry is, the thing that you enjoy the most.
What I enjoy the most is getting with the different dealers, the different manufacturers, the different salespeople, and just communicating with one another, learning different aspects of what they do differently, what we do differently as a corporate entity. I love to speak and talk to the independents. You know, they do a lot of different things than what we do, and we do a lot of different things than what they do. So just the communicating and for lack of a better word, the fellowship, you know, it's an amazing part of this business. But what I really, really, really enjoy is that satisfaction of handing someone their keys to their new home, knowing that I played a big part into helping them achieve their goal. And to watch the children running through their home, this is my room. This is where I'm going to put this. This is where I'm going to put that. And watching the mother in the kitchen and watching the father in the den. And I get very emotional and I apologize. But it's that feeling, that warm and fluffy and loving feeling that I get when I've helped someone get into a new home. It's amazing.
It's helping those people, you know, achieve the American dream of home ownership. And it's likely the largest investment they'll ever make. And they've put their whole heart, soul, and trust in Sue LeBlanc and Clayton Homes. And I think that's just a fantastic way to look at it. And let's talk about new people entering our business. The new folks that are just starting out and they want to be a Sue someday. What might be a tip, suggestion that you might give someone entering the business today that can help them to pursue their goals?
Give 150%. Do what you have to do daily. Continue to learn. I learn every day something new. Even though I've been doing this for years, I learn something new every day. And the day that you, or the moment that you stop learning, you can give it up because you have to continue to learn. You have to be a sponge. You have to be able to absorb just as much knowledge as you can. Talk to different people, learn from different people. No one is the same. No one manages the same. No one sells the same. But if you just open up your world and just let it all come in, you can learn a lot. Just continue to learn. Work very hard. Just if someone asks you to do something, just do it. And don't ask questions. Just do it.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more. I've had a chance now to visit. It's well over 1,400 locations, retail and community locations across the country. And you just hit on it. And I call it the best of the best. You know, every company that I talk to, they seem to do one or two things exceptionally well. And to take those ideas like you're talking about and learn and share and just, as you mentioned, sponge to absorb these things. It's just essential. And they're going to see changes as it goes on. You've seen in your career, in the years that you've been in this business, some big changes. If you could maybe take a moment, share with us some of the biggest changes that you've seen in your career.
The internet is one of the biggest changes. You know, when I first got in the business, if you wanted to see a manufactured home, you literally had to get in your vehicle and go to the nearest dealership. Now, everyone just jumps on the internet, clicks on a button, and there are virtual walkthroughs, there are floor plans, there are just about anything that you want to know about a manufactured home is on the internet. It's very helpful, although it doesn't have that personal interaction. Mm-hmm. You know, you can walk through a home, but unless you have someone there that can actually feature benefit that home to you, tell you why it's a good feature to have. What is the benefit of that feature? Right. The internet can't do that. Oh yes, you can see colors and the pretties and the all the things about it, but you can't get the that personal interaction.
Sure. I agree with you.
So that is one of the biggest changes I've seen, that just being able to see the product online. Couple of other changes I've seen is that we are allowed to now put our product in places that didn't want us before. Now we still have a big challenge ahead of us with that. A lot of, you know, inner city municipalities still don't allow our product in there as of yet, but we're working very hard on that, getting with our local governments and whatnot. But we're making a difference. We're changing how people perceive our product.
Yeah, it's you're so right. And speaking of product, one of the things that is a pet peeve of mine is visiting a location and looking at homes. And let's back it up a moment. We go to a manufactured home show. I know Clayton does the big shows as well as the national shows. And you go to these shows and you see these homes and they look virtually perfect for us. And we know the product. But from your perspective, maybe share with our listeners and our viewers the importance of staging your home properly and maybe add a couple tips or tricks that you do.
Well, it's very important to stage the home. You know, you can walk into a building or an empty home and you just don't see what it actually could be. Where would I put the TV? Where would I put my favorite recliner? Where can I put my couch? And so by staging our homes here at our home center, a customer can walk in and, oh my God, I didn't think my recliner would look good in this particular space. So it's very important for a customer or a prospective buyer to be able to see what their completed project would look like by having the pictures on the walls, the plates on the table. And the people that I use to stage my home, they're phenomenal. They'll use local artists to put their pictures on our walls and stuff. So it's things that other places can't get a hold to because it's unique. So we do allow our clients to purchase everything we have in the home or just a piece, you know, or sometimes, and I'm ashamed to say this, but most of the time, oh, Sue, I love that picture. It's yours. You can have it.
Sure. Yeah. You know, that's such a great, great suggestion. And we talked earlier, you mentioned, I should say, that we learn something new every day. You've just given me something I've never thought about, using the local artists, the local vendors in your community to show off their ware, show off their painting, show off their pictures. What a great, great idea. And for all of you out there, just think about that and what you might do in your local community. But Sue, let me ask this. You've done it a long time. You've been successful. You're admired by your peers. But when all is said and done, maybe share with us, what's the one thing that you're most proud of?
Oh, there's so many things that I am so proud of. I'm proud of my family, my daughter, who is a very successful teacher, my son-in-law, who is an awesome, awesome dad and husband. My husband, who has supported me 150%, my success here. I am so proud of the team that I have. I am so proud of the company that I work for. I've said it many, many a times. If you cut my wrist, I bleed green and blue. So I am 150,000% Clayton. These guys are just so supportive of everything that we do locally and on the corporate level. I'm just proud of life in itself. Life is great. Life is good. I don't know. I'm overwhelmed with success and with my family and my company. I'm very proud of a lot of things, Ken.
Well, let me go back to your favorite quote that says, what good is your life if you never live it? What good is your story if you never tell it? And what good is your smile if you never share it? And Sue, You've shared all of that with us today. And I want to thank you so, so very much for taking some of the valuable time in your busy day to chat with us. But maybe somebody wants to reach out to you. Maybe say, boy, this Sue LeBlanc, she's really something special. And what would be the best way, pardon me, for someone to reach out or contact you?
Well, again, my cell phone number. My cell phone number is 337-339-1961. Or by email, which is Susan, S-U-S-A-N, dot LeBlanc, L-E-B, as in boy, L-A-N-C, at claytonhomes.com.
Well, with that, folks, I want to thank Susan again for joining us today. And for all of you out there, on behalf of Sue and I, we wish you the absolute best. And we'll see you on the next edition of the Manufactured Home Show. Wave goodbye, Sue.
Bye. Thank you.